Well, President Trump expected to announce today that he's going to delay the end of the DACA program to give Congress 6 months to legitimize that program. So he'll end DACA, but there's going to be some time here. DACA stands for Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals. It protects illegal young immigrants to the United States from getting deported. Now, it was created by executive order from President Obama back in 2012. So without Congress on board, House Speaker Paul Ryan, though, and other Republicans have been urging the president to postpone scrapping DACA until Congress can come up with some type of legislative fix. We expect to hear more about this today from Attorney General Jeff Sessions. For more on the DACA program, let's bring in, though, David Bruno. He's a former criminal prosecutor and criminal defense attorney at the Bianchi Law Group. David, good morning.
Good morning, Cheryl.
All right. So as far as scrapping the program goes, do you think the president is making the right decision? Because the timing seems to be a little rough with everything else that's happening in Washington this morning.
Yeah, fundamentally, I do. I do agree, because what happened was in 2012, when President Obama could not pass actual legislation through Congress with the Dreamer Act, he signed an executive order that is only temporary. And it's not federal law. In fact, the federal law is, generally speaking, people that are here legally can be deported. And when he signed this executive order, he postponed the actual law. So by President Trump making this decision, he's in essence throwing it back to Congress to say, this is your decision, this is the proper way to go about this business, and I do agree this is the way to go.
You know, it's interesting, David, because it seems like the president is doing what President Obama should have done. He didn't work with Congress. He didn't get the DREAM Act passed. President Obama didn't. And now President Trump is saying, you know, hey, executive order aside, let's stop with the executive orders and let Congress work it out. But at the same time, Congress is the key here. Paul Ryan, Mitch McConnell have both made comments about either we should protect these young individuals, we're sympathetic. Sometimes these are kids that are 16, 17, 18 years old. Do you think that the President Trump will agree with whatever the decision they end up making in Congress?
Yeah, I do. And that's the key takeaway here, because this could be spun a different way, that president is against the Dreamers. And that's not necessarily true. What he's saying is the proper way to go about this is through Congress. And that's what the decision is today. And he's giving them a six-month window, and maybe it's not going to happen in 6 months, and I would probably bet that President Trump would extend that if they needed more time. It sounds like a page from The Art of the Deal.
Yeah, it's interesting you bring up that six-month issue, because I was wondering if that was enough time, considering all the other problems that Congress has had getting legislation through. 6 months seems kind of a short window.
Yeah, well, six months is the time frame, and like I said, it could be extended, I'm sure. But I think Congress acts better with deadlines. When they're up against the six-month timetable, they know that a decision has to be made.
David Bruno, well, we're going to hear from the president, or actually from Attorney General Jeff Sessions, we expect to later today, that announcement coming out of Washington as well, with all kinds of other stuff. David, thank you.
You're welcome. Good morning.
All right.